Dispatch, this is car 26.
We have arrived at the Hempfield Church of the Brethren. I'm escorting prisoner 803-211 inside. Over.
Copy, car 26.
So the warden said, I do a couple of these talks. Maybe I'm eligible for some more privs. He didn't make any promises, though. He never does. I ain't making no promises either. In fact, I really don't care if you listen or not. This world ain't real to me anyway. Half of you are in prison, too. You just don't know it. Everyone calls me Smoke. My real name's none of your business. You ain't earned the right to know it. You do something for me back inside, maybe I'll tell you. They call me Smoke because I burned down a building for $2,000. Turns out there were some people inside. I didn't know that. Judge and jury didn't seem to care. I got 20 years for doing that. Done 18 so far. Supposed to be eligible for parole soon. Well, I guess this is a part where I'm supposed to tell you I had a bad childhood. How my dad beat me every night. My mom left with some random dude when I was 6 years old. How I watched my brother get gunned down across the street. Well, I ain't crying about that stuff, and I don't need your sympathy. Half the old neighborhood's locked up, the other half's dead. They're the lucky ones. I'm on D block up in Lewisburg with all the other scumbags. Most of them are doing life for murder and whatnot. First thing you gotta do when you get inside is get with a gang. I represent the ECF, East Coast Freaks. No one messes with us because they know we're always ready, bang. They're my brothers, they're like the family I never had. Some dudes get letters once in a while. I wrote a few when I first got in. Didn't hear nothing back, so I figured, what's the point? About once a week, you can go to the chaplain service if you want to. My boys and I never go. I know where I'm going. My ticket's already punched. Some dudes inside got religion. There's Christians and Muslims and some other stuff. Is always trying to get you to sign up. One dude gave me this New Testament. I read it once in a while, I ain't gonna lie. Not like I'm real busy. This is the last thing I read. You have heard that it was said, love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be sons of your Father in heaven. He causes the sun to rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. If you love those who love you, what reward will you get? Are not even the tax collectors doing that? And if you greet only your brothers, what are you doing more than others? Do not even pagans do that? Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect. I got some enemies. They ain't you, because I really don't care about you one way or the other. I bet you think I'm your enemy, though. I bet if I came by, oh, you'd put your kids behind you real quick, wouldn't you? My enemies are the people from the trial, the families of the people who were inside that building when it burned down. Two guys and a girl. All during the trial, they was looking at me with eyes full of hate, like I had killed them with my bare hands or something. And the judge, he's saying, you're a menace, and you need to think about what you did. And they led me away. Eventually, you get where you're going, and they strip you naked, and they give you these, and they put you in the cell, and they slam the door shut. That's the first time in my life I ever remember being scared. I didn't sleep for 3 days. And I've been dying a little bit every day ever since. Sometimes at night, I can still smell the gas from that job. Man, I put it all over the walls to make sure. There weren't any cars in the parking lot. I checked. I'm a lot of things, but I ain't no killer. Well, back then I wasn't anyway. Now I ain't so sure. I guess some of you are waiting to hear how sorry I am for what I done. Right, Dribber? That I changed my ways, that I'm rehabilitated, that I'm ready to become a law-abiding citizen. Yee-haw. Whose law, huh? Seems to me the people with the money make the laws, and most of them cheated to get where they are. You ask me, there ain't much difference between robbing a 7-Eleven and talking some old lady out of her savings. Change. I'll change when there's a reason to. What am I supposed to do when I get out anyway? You gonna give me a job? You guys? How about this section here? You guys gonna give me a job when I get out? You? If you were smart, you'd pray I'd do somebody back inside so they lock me up forever. Maybe you're wondering what you can do to help me. Ain't that what you guys do? Try to find poor slobs you can help? You want to do something for me and put me out of my misery? Call those families I destroyed and tell them to meet me in the parking lot with a shotgun after this so they can have their revenge. At least then, my life was worth something to somebody. Sometimes I lie there on my crusty mattress and I think, what if? What if I hadn't needed $2,000 in 1993? I know 50 guys done worse stuff than me, and they're free as birds. But you only get one chance in this life. And I blew mine. Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect. Looks like I ain't gonna make that one. Tell you what, though. How about a show of hands? Everybody who's made it to perfect so far, why don't you raise one up? Hey, buddy, who's perfect out here, huh? what I thought. Maybe we ain't so different after all. You see, you don't really know what to do with me, do you? So you pretend I don't exist, and I don't really. Not to you. You see, someone gives you a hard time, you can just write them off. You can go find somebody who looks and thinks and acts a little bit more like you. Like it said in the book, it's easy to love those who love you back. Even the lifers can do that. How you gonna love me, huh? There ain't nothing good about me! Nothing! Don't you get it? I was the one who beat up your kid on the playground. I was the reason you lock your doors at night. When it says that God causes the evil to rise, the sun to rise on the evil and the good, who do you think he's talking about? There ain't nothing good about me because I ain't nothing! Don't you get it? You wipe stuff off the bottom of your shoe. It's worth more than me. It's the only thing my old man ever got right. He said, son, you're a worthless piece of garbage, and that's all you're ever gonna be. You wanna know what it's like to be me? When I was a kid, we'd catch bugs, and we'd put them in a jar, and we'd screw the lid on tight. And then bugs, they would always run up to the top. And when they got to the top, we'd turn it upside down again. And then bugs, they would run up to the top again. But when they got there, we'd turn it over. And they'd just keep doing that, and we'd keep turning it over, laughing at them. Stupid bugs. Eventually, they would just die. Now I'm the one in the jar. And I'm tired of climbing. I just want to die.
Dispatch to Trooper Wright. Dispatch to Trooper Wright.
Dispatch, go ahead.
Lewisburg Warden instructs the prisoner 803211 has made parole and is to be immediately released. Over.
Confirm, dispatch. You want me to release my prisoner under his own recognizance?
Confirm. Release your prisoner.
Set it up. Turn around. Free smoke.
My hope secure. amazing grace.